Good morning, everyone. My name is Todd Eklund. I'm Vice President of Instruction here at Coastal Bend College. On behalf of Dr. B. Espinoza, I would like to welcome you to our ribbon cutting for our pollinator area here at Coastal Bend. Unfortunately, President Espinoza cannot be with us this morning. I want to give you just a quick little information before we get going here with some other things. January of 2016, Nick Ottesman and Coastal Bend College trustees Laura Fisher and Martha Warner contacted Dr. Espinoza to express her interest in the Bee City USA and Bee Campus USA campaigns. These campaigns are designed to promote healthy, sustainable habitats and communities for bees and other pollinators. Dr. Espinoza and Dean Mark Secord carried the Bee USA initiative forward and met with the city manager. They also gave presentations to Progressive Bee County and the City Council. In April 2016, the City of Beeville agreed to move forward with their proposal to apply for the Bee City USA designation. Soon after, Coastal Bend College sought and was granted Bee Campus USA status. The City of Beeville and Coastal Bend College jointly proclaimed their respective designations as Bee City and Bee Campus on June 25th of 2016. So this has been an ongoing process of about a year long. At this time, just real quick, I'm going to ask our Board of Trustees President, Ms. Fisher, if she wants to say a couple of things, seeing how she was instrumental in this, plus she's the Board President. I have to, you know, it's one of those things.
Thank you, Dr. Welcome, everyone. We're so glad to see you all here, and it's exciting to be here. It's a great deal. I want to, these gentlemen are going to give you all the details of what happened and had happened. Martha just read it in a magazine, calls Nick, Nick calls me, I call B, and here we are. So we need to stop and thank the forefathers of this college for this property that we've got. If we didn't have this property, we can't put bees in the middle of the campus and let them buzz everybody. So we need to think about the great things that the foresight they had 51 years ago, 52 years ago probably, to put this together and have some property around. We have Lake Louise, and I hope before I get off this board we have signage and that lake filled up all the time to have the bees have some water available. And the gentlemen, I believe, have planted everything and it's going to look gorgeous. But again, we've got great faculty and staff and the expertise here to keep these bees going. We can't lose them. And they're pollinating things like onions and avocados and cantaloupe and all those good things that we love. And we can't definitely let those guys die. And we love the butterflies, right, Mark? Mm-hmm. Okay, so help us here. We see everybody's here to welcome us. And thank you guys and the expertise at this college to make it happen. Thank you so much.
I don't know if everybody knows this, but our bees are Italian bees, and they are coming from Italy. The travel ban didn't change, so they should be able to get here. That's my joke for the day.
That's terrible.
Thank you. At this time, I'd like to introduce Mr. Mark Secord. He's Dean of Academics at CBC, and really kind of once these ladies and the president said we're going to do this, Mark really kind of spearheaded this thing for us from the campus side of things. So, Mark, here, I'll hold your sign for you, sir.
Yes, thank you. Yes, and I just want to give you a little background. First of all, thank you for coming, because without your support, this couldn't happen. And thank you to Laura Fisher and Martha and Nick for starting this initiative to begin with. And let me kind of give you a little background and explain why this is so incredibly important. A lot of people think, oh, that's interesting, but they don't understand what's behind this. See, as far as the history, about as early as the 1950s, we started recognizing that bee colonies were dying. We're losing them. Then about the mid-1980s, we really saw a massive decline because we had some parasites show up, the Asian honeybee came in, we had some viruses that were transmitted, and we started having massive losses. In 2012 in North Carolina, a group of beekeepers got together and they said, you know what, we have to do something about this. We're losing honeybee colonies at an alarming rate, and they started a grassroots effort, and they started with the B Campus USA Initiative and the B City Campus Initiative. And these initiatives were all about, first of all, pollination awareness. So what do pollinators do? Why are they so important? And why specifically are honeybees so incredibly important? And a lot of people don't realize it, but over 90 of our commercially grown crops in North America rely on honeybee pollination. No honeybees, you'd lose a lot of crops. There would be no almonds without honeybees. There'd be no apples. There'd be no blueberries. So very, very important. And I was reading up on some of the stats. Of all the flowering plants, over 90% of them require pollinators, insect pollinators. A third of every food product that we eat is a product of honeybees. So they're critical. And in the last 35 years, we've lost 45% of our honeybee colonies. In fact, the native, see, a lot of people don't understand, our native colonies have been decimated. We rely on European honeybees that were brought over. That's over about 300 years ago. Without the bees, our ecosystems would collapse. Critical, critical need. And this decline, you know, I say 45% decline over the last 35 years or so, it's continuing at a rate of 30 or 40% every year on the honeybee side. So we have to do something to reverse it. And that's where the initiative came through. Now, we were established as the 13th Bee Campus USA. There are only three in Texas, and we are the first and only community college in the state of Texas that is a bee campus. Yeah, that's something we really need to be proud of. And so we're going to make a difference, and it's all about education, which is what we do, so making people aware of how important pollinators are, but also in doing our part in protecting the habitat and furthering the resources and supporting your own colony. And I'll introduce Nick in a little bit, but we're very, very fortunate that we have Nick as a resource, tremendous resource. But what we did is we went to Dr. Espinosa after we were given this charge that take care of it. And I said, well, we're looking for a site where we can do this. And she said, well, there's a really good area outside Lake Louise, it's yours. And it's pretty amazing that she turned a couple of administrators and a banker loose with a chainsaw and a tractor and said, go for it. I mean, total leap of faith. So I really commend her for putting that confidence in us, and just, she turned us loose. And I'd say, this is what I want to do, and this, you know, we're going to do, and she's like, take care of it. So that was really tremendous. Without her support, this wouldn't happen. And this is not the finished product. This is not the end. This is the beginning. I mean, we designated the property. We cleaned it up. It's been planted, by the way. So we have a very diverse flower mix in there, which should provide plenty of habitat for the pollinators. Nick's getting everything set up on the bee side. So, you know, this is hopefully the start of a long, like Ms. Fisher said, a long series of habitat improvements that we can do. And so we can keep conserving pollinators. So thank you, all of you, for being here and supporting this. As we've been working on this, you know, community members have been coming by on the track, and a lot of them have stopped. What are you doing? Well, we're putting in a like pollination garden, and you know, to help out the honeybees and whatnot. And every one of them was, that's so exciting. That is great. So there's a lot of enthusiasm. And you know, occasionally you get individuals that were a little concerned about the bees. Like, no, we're setting it up responsibly. But a lot of support. So thank you to the board members, the board president, that means everything. Nick, I mean, this group right here is really what made it all happen. And before I introduce Nick, I'd like to thank some other people, because something like this isn't, you know, done by two or three people. It's a group effort. And David Rome in the back was a tremendous help. So when we needed, you know, hardware and tractors, we'd go to David. JC, is JC here?
He's in training class.
Okay. JC, who's in charge of maintenance grounds, he gave us whatever we needed. Some of the grounds guys would come out and help us prep stuff. Mr. Signs, Bernie there, helped. He was very involved in the project. We had Dr. Eklund on the tractor. I mean, Nick out there getting dirty, so we were all involved. So thank you, all of you, for what you did. And now it's
hang
my
on,
pleasure.
Hang on. Yeah. More importantly, we need to thank Mark because he was out here one Friday afternoon, and I walked out here, and it was Friday, so I was dressed like this, and he was getting ready to start the disking and the plowing and the chiseling and all of that, and to get those implements moved around and do what he needed to do, there was no way he was going to get it done himself. But he was going to do it himself if he had to. So he spent several weekends out here with limited help from me. I mean, come on, I got a doctorate in education. What do I know, right? He's a biologist. Mark, tell me what to do kind of thing. But Mark really spearheaded this thing and drove the ship and did a fantastic job managing this whole project. So, very
like I said, it really was a labor of love. Nick, you know, totally understand that. We are both just excited. And now we're, where do we go from here? Oh, we can do this. When we get together, it gets dangerous.
Yeah, yeah, that's right.
So without further ado, it's really my privilege and honor to introduce Nick Ottesman. He is our local bee expert. I mean, he set all this up, and really from this point on, we're handing it over to Nick and say, work your magic. So thank you, Nick.
Thank you, Mark. Thank you to everyone. This is really great. I mean, Mark, you said all my stuff, but you said it well, and he's exactly right. This is just the beginning. This is something that we hope to expand upon. It's something that we can really enjoy as a community. I mean, this is for our pollinators, who we of course love and appreciate, and this is what drives all this. This is for the community. This is for y'all. Y'all come by. We want to put some chairs out here for y'all to enjoy these wildflowers. It's not just for the folks running by. This is going to be a neat thing. So, and of course, you have thousands of different pollinators, not just honeybees. The benefit of having your honeybees is honey, of course, and we plan to have some Coastal Bend honey for sale in the near future, so be looking for that. But other than that, it's something that I hope my kids get to say, you know, my dad was a part of this. You know, he's a part of kind of making this happen. And again, we hope to elaborate on it and really turn it into something special. So thank you all for being here and for your support. And that's really all I have.
Great. Thank you. All right, just a couple things and we'll turn it over to the chamber for the formal ribbon cutting ceremony. Coastal Bend College is excited to have this opportunity to contribute to the mission of sustaining and growing viable populations and pollinators. Our mild climate combined with an abundance of agriculture and wildflowers makes this region extremely attractive to pollinators of all varieties. As a college, we're just excited about this. Science classes can come out here and do things. Our art students can come out here and draw pictures or take pictures or whatever, wildflowers and all of that. Community, you wouldn't believe the number of people that use this track on a regular basis. Every day when Mark and I were out here, there was people. Not so much during the heat of the day, but later on. A couple of crazy people were out in the heat of the day. And so, again, it's for them. They can be able to see this and all of this. So we appreciate you all coming today. I'm going to turn it over to the chamber for the official cutting.
Sure.
And who do you want over there?
Well, the chamber, we're excited to be supporting this initiative, the Bee City Campus, and also the Bee City USA. And we'll be helping them in June when the Pollinators Week comes along and there's some events. So with that said, we'll get, of course, all of the people that, you know, Laura and all of y'all that were in, and the ones that put this together and the initiators, and y'all will be in the middle, and then we can get everybody else behind on the sides if y'all want. So y'all can all come forward.
Come on, baby, come on, you're gonna get that towel.
I got your email.
Maybe on top of one, or have it on top of
one. Can we get behind that?
Behind that and on top.
Got a wide angle, Jason.
You can walk down here, guys. I'm going to walk down here.
Two of our back and trample our seats.
Yeah, I think it would be nice to be right in front of this.
It isn't rained yet. I don't know if it's here.
Are we sitting here or are they not here yet?
On this side, and you and Laura cut. Where did it go?
There's the sign.
The sign,
How wide is this frame? Do we need them right in the morning?
Oh, yeah. A lot.
I'm sorry, Jason.
Okay, ready?
Hang on.
Hold on.
The photographers.
Okay. So, view this way. I cannot see you. So, y'all gotta come this way.
Again, you guys can go around on the back side of the fence.
The rest of y'all either behind or
behind me.
Can we put enough nails in, Mark?
Can you get them all? All right. Yeah, I got them. Okay. We're going to do one with before you cut it, and then we'll do one with you cutting it.
Okay.
On three, guys. One, two, three. Okay, now we're going to get you to cut it on three. One, two, three.
Guess what?
Hey David, will you take the scissors and go sharpen them real quick?